Hi, my name is Lou, and I welcome you to another episode of my Minecraft single player world. Now, I'm aware this is quite different from the last two episodes. I finally gave in and started looking for mods, and I went eastward from spawn, and I found this. But Lou, you might say, there's no moss in jungles, moss is only found in shipwrecks. I'm very aware of that. And I'm still here, because I saw that. So I guess we're starting today by exploring a jungle temple. Now, I don't think the layout of jungle temples has changed considerably since I've last been in one, and I don't think the loot has changed either. Although I'm actually not quite aware what exactly is found in jungle temples. In the chest. Nope, that is going to shoot me. That is going to try to shoot me as well. Okay, bones and gold. That's pretty boring. But it's a jungle temple, which is cool. And I've got arrows and... Honestly, the best thing about this is probably the dispensers and the redstone components. And then there's this thing, right? I have no idea if there's actually a solution to this riddle. Maybe there is? Although I don't see how those two pistons would open anything up. But there's some more bones here. And some pistons, which is, again, probably the good loot in here. So, yeah, the loot isn't the best, but it's a jungle temple, which is pretty cool. And yeah, I think I'll be exploring the jungle a bit more because it is well within 1,000 blocks from spawn. Well, yeah, I've got 200 more blocks and loads of blocks in that direction. Although I should probably really go back on the open sea and start looking for moss. Look, that's the northern icy ocean right next to the jungle. That's really interesting, that generation. I really like this seed. Hi, will you please be my friend? Oh, come on. There's not that much grass around here. I already destroyed it all. Well, you know what? The green parrots are much cooler than you anyways. Oh, come on. Know what? There we go. Oh my god. It's boss! It's boss, it's boss, it's boss! I have moss! Oh, finally! I'm so happy. Oh, I have moss! That's amazing! Yeah, it's right here by the jungle. I found some moss. Alright, now that we have finally found some moss, can finally start working on the outside of the house. And I've done a little bit of that, as you can see right here. So this is kind of the vibe I'm going for the entire area. This kind of level of detail. And yeah, I'm really happy with this. I like all the plants and it's really green and still not boring. I've got some amethyst here in the water, which is nice. And over here I've got a bit of a kitchen garden. For the kitchen, that's not a kitchen yet, but this is a bit of a kitchen garden here. Now, what you may have noticed is that there's no custom trees around yet. There's only some signs saying tree, as if that would change anything. Yeah, I'm not entirely sure what kind of tree to build here, and yeah, scale is a problem. I'm only really used to small custom trees, and I want bigger trees around here. What I have started to do is kind of these birch trees here that will border the wheat field. I have made this at first and I'm not happy with it. It just looks like a ball of leaves and it's not nice. After that I've built this one, which is just a bit too chaotic and generally weird in my opinion. Especially for a birch tree, it doesn't look like a birch tree. And this is the third tree I've built, which I'm happy with, actually. Obviously, it's not entirely perfect, but it doesn't need to be, because it's a tree and trees are natural and not perfect. So what I'll do is I'll chop this tree down and chop this tree down and replace all of these trees and all of those signs along here with trees like that. Man, I have this weird feeling that I'm not alone in my house. I'm not entirely sure where it's from, but there's just this sinking feeling in my stomach that there's someone in here with me. Let's investigate. Excuse me, sir! What are you doing in my house? Now doesn't that look much better? I definitely do like it this way. The only problem is that as of now it's a literal tree line. It's a line of trees and not like the edge of a forest. So I will need more trees like this. And I've done a bit of calculation and I think on average I need about 20 minutes for one of those trees. And I'm sure I could cut that down to like 15 or 10 minutes. And I think I'll just start popping up new trees every now and then when I feel like it to make this like an actual forest. And maybe I'll actually chop down some of these trees again. Just because this kind of sets the precedent of a dense forest with many trees. And if I want to be lazy and do less trees, then maybe I should have this tree line also have less trees in it. Alright, I'm currently trying to find out whether a llama can spit on a button and activate it. Come on, you can hit that. It's kind of random where exactly it shoots, but it seems to shoot in my direction because it's angry at me. I know that arrows and skeletons with their arrows can trigger wooden buttons. So I think that any projectile would work. Although, do like eggs work? I think I should test whether eggs actually work. Because if eggs don't, then it might be an arrow thing and not a projectile thing in general. Nope. Okay, it's an arrow thing. Aww. Come here, I want you to activate my bee farm. Oh my goodness. This should work, shouldn't it? Come on, hit this button. Ha! It worked! Look, it's coming in! So that works! Now I can activate my bee farm by hitting this llama. But maybe I shouldn't just change it back. Because that's not very pretty right now. You know, sometimes I feel like I'm going crazy. It's like, when you go in a cave, right? Either you're out in 5 minutes, or you're gonna spend like 10 hours and 13 stacks of torches in this cave. And this is one of these caves where you spend hours and hours and hours and torches and torches and torches in. So this is a pretty huge cave system. It leads to 2 amethyst geodes, as well as a bunch of spawners. There's a zombie spawner somewhere, as well as a mineshaft with actually a double cave spider spawner, which is pretty nice. And there's a skeleton spawner somewhere here. I've marked down the coordinates, I'm just gonna have to find it again. And that is where we're going to build a farm now. Because I really need bone meal, a lot of bone meal when I want to do greenery. And even though you can farm bone meal with moss nowadays, I just like having mob spawners around. If I can find the skeleton spawner again. Okay, I'm completely lost. I think I'll just go back to the surface. Try to go back to the surface anyways. And dig down straight into the skeleton spawner. And I'll see you there. Okay, this is not the way out, but it's the way to the spawners. I've gone the completely wrong direction from the very beginning. What I need to do is I need to go here and down here. And then over here, if I go through here, there's like a bunch of ravines all going into each other. I found my way again. At least this is the way towards the spawner. I'm not entirely sure if I'm gonna find the exact coordinates of the spawner without digging. But this is where we need to go. There's still ways that I haven't lit up yet. My goodness. I spent many hours in here yesterday, essentially the entire day, and I'm still not done. Obviously, this is not the way to the skeleton spawner. Again. But I believe the skeleton spawner was actually pretty much on the edge of where I got with my torches. I think I only put one torch at the spawner itself because I was, like, completely out of torches at that point in time. Look at that. There's another spawner. I haven't found that one yet. It's only zombies. But, yeah. That's two zombie spawners in this entire region of caves. Now, what would make me happy is to actually find that skeleton spawner I was talking about. I promise it's there. I mean, somewhere. The question is, where exactly is it? Is it over here? No, 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 no. I remember this. I've been here before. I should probably just look at the coordinates I've written down. But I just want to find the skeleton spawner myself. Alright, so please don't actually listen to Lou from 10 minutes ago. They were a bit of an idiot. And you might say, but Lou, you're still the same person as you were 10 minutes ago. Yes, I am. But I have now accepted, momentarily, that being too stubborn is maybe not the best thing to do. Momentarily. I'm gonna be stubborn again very soon. But this is my skeleton spawner. It is not probably lit up because I ran out of torches the first time I got here, and I ran out of torches again the second time I got here. So I'm probably just gonna go away from here again to get more torches, and then I'm gonna start building an actual farm. Alright, I think I've got almost everything I need ready. I only need you. You've got a very important job to do, buddy. So, I've been thinking. I want to be able to watch the skeletons through tinted glass. I'll have a wall of tinted glass here, I think. And then behind that is my killing chamber. Now, when we already have the ability to watch our skeletons spawn and die through the tinted glass, why don't we have a bit of fun with it? Even though I do need the bones, just going for efficiency is boring, isn't it? So the plan is to put a slime block launcher in here, and in here, and the skeletons from this corner are going to get launched directly into this water stream that leads to the kill chamber. And the skeletons from this corner, meanwhile, are going to be launched into this corner, and then into this corner. And I'll be funneling them to my kill chamber. Which is actually probably gonna be on that side after all. Mostly because I already have a tunnel in here that goes up to the surface. And I don't want to dig another tunnel that goes up to the surface. Alright, the first module is in. So what's going to happen is skeletons are spawning, and they're getting scared of this little guy. And when they fall into one of these, then this happens. They get catapulted into another corner. And then while we're killing the skeletons, we're standing around here or something, we're killing skeletons, And they're all jumping around. It's gonna be great, I hope. I hope it's gonna be great. I hope it's gonna work at all. If it doesn't work, then we'll have to just go for a regular, boring old skeleton farm. Alright. I think it should work now. As well as it's gonna work anyways. So, the skeletons are going to be scared of this dog and run into one of these holes and then be flung into this hole. That's the theory. Now, of course, I'm not without concerns. For one, I'm not sure whether one dog is enough. And maybe I will need to put more dogs if the skeletons all stand here because they think they are far away enough from the dog. In addition to that, during testing, I repeatedly ran into the problem that one skeleton would be flung here, and then between when this piston fired and this piston fired, another skeleton would run inside. And then there would be a skeleton stuck inside one of these things and essentially keep this wire that is powering the whole thing down. And because of that, nothing would work anymore. So my fix for that is that these two, this one and that one, are connected. So whenever one of them fires, the other one fires as well. And therefore, when one is stuck in here, then as soon as one would go into here, the stuck one would also get flung. With this one, I've solved it slightly differently. You can see there's no observer here at all. That is because I've made this flinger depending on when this flinger flings. So this thing fires, and then a while later this fires. And it's actually pretty perfect. Usually. It works most of the time. Not always. It doesn't work all the time, but that's okay, because we have managed... Oh, come on! Are you not working anymore? I double-checked this. Okay, I might need to adjust everything. Okay. I think you're firing too early. You know, here I was proudly trying to show off what I did, and then it's not work. And now it works! Sure! So yeah, it's not foolproof. That's why I've tried to foolproof it a little bit more. Torches are gone. I'll run away. And then I have a lever here, which should enable the spawner. Hey! Okay, two skeletons were flung. A third skeleton is flung. Ha! I love it! That's amazing. Hi! But I am quite surprised. As long as I don't get stuck in that hole, it seems to work really well. Much better than I expected, to be completely honest. Alright, I've made some improvements. Changes. I made some changes. In that, I now have four dogs in here. Two of which are actually scaring the skeletons on the ground. One scares the skeletons in case they fall on top of the two dogs on the ground. And that one back there is just being a great boy. Just such a good boy. I have no idea whether that dog does anything whatsoever. And I also don't know whether these three dogs are any more helpful than one dog in the middle would be. But this is what I've got, and it works. Skeletons do still get stuck in some places, but usually they're not stuck for long. And the only real problem I'm seeing for this farm to not work anymore is if both that hole and this hole have skeletons stuck in them, and then none of the slime block launchers will fire at all. Now that is quite unlikely, as far as I can tell. And it should be easy to fix if I just add some kind of manual button that can just trigger the system once. Knowing myself, I probably won't implement that until I actually have a problem though. But that's fine. So it works. It makes me super happy to look at. It's so much fun to just watch. And it's pretty effective too. I would also definitely say that this is pretty good for XP farming. Usually I've been using my witch farm, but this is faster, I think. Just because there's more skeletons coming in than witches are coming in at the witch farm. I'm almost at 50 levels, which is pretty crazy. I've not really been paying attention. I've just kind of been sitting here watching a show and grinding away. And as you can see, all of my tools are mended as well, which is really nice. And there's something else I got, which is a trident. I found this on one of my little expeditions throughout the ocean, and I was not recording at the moment, and I did not have OBS open either, so I couldn't actually show you how I got it. But I do have a trident, and I put Riptide on it, and thanks to the skeleton farm I had enough experience to make it fully functioning. And that is pretty cool, I'd say. So let's actually test this trident out on our way home, which I usually do swimming. It's kind of... I mean, it's... Oh, I see. You gotta go through air with it, and then it's fun. But if you just go through water, you kind of need to charge it a lot. But what happens if you don't charge? You just get... Okay, so you definitely want to fully charge it. And then you do not want to stay inside the water throughout your trident throw. But you want to... Hit a squid, apparently. But no, you want to fly through the air. And then it's actually cool. And fast. This is fun, I have to say. I don't know how applicable it is outside of situations like this, where you have like an actual river that's kind of deep, and you definitely need a lot of water around to fall into again. It might be time to actually upgrade my armor and get some feather falling on my boots. Because if I'm gonna keep doing this, I will keep taking fall damage. That is for sure. But I'm afraid that must have been it for today. We've made a skeleton farm, we've made some really pretty birch trees over there, and we have found ourselves a cool trident. Ouch! Oh, I'll see you next time. Bye bye!